Welcome to Connecting a ProScript Device to a Citrix Server. Step 1. Install ScripTouch Sign and Save locally. Open your browser and go to scriptel.com/support/downloads. This is the place on the ScripTel site where all of our software that is available for public use is kept. Scroll down to the ScripTouch Sign and Save area and click the blue Download Now button to begin the download process. When the End User License Agreement appears, confirm that you accept the terms by clicking on the radio button. Step 2. Install ScripTouch Toolbox locally. Scroll down to the area that says ScripTouch Toolbox. Click the blue Download Now button to download and start installing the software onto your local machine. When the End User License Agreement appears, confirm that you accept the terms by clicking on the radio button. Now, before we begin the next step, I'm going to minimize the browser to get it out of our way. Step 3. Configure the pad settings in the toolbox. Open the local copy of the ScripTouch toolbox by double-clicking on its icon. In the menu, select Settings and then Online Settings. Enter your username and password, then click Check Credentials. Make sure your primary organization is set correctly and then click Save. Under Settings, make sure Enable Online is checked. Under Settings, click Check for Licenses. This will download the license file to your computer. You can confirm the license is downloaded by looking under the Help tab in License Viewer. Now I'm going to minimize the toolbox before we begin the next step. Step 4. Install ScripTouch Sign and Save on the Citrix server. Double-click the Citrix icon to open the Citrix desktop. This might take some time, so please be patient. Open up a browser and go to the page scriptel.com/support/downloads. This is the page that we went to earlier and has all of the downloads for ScripTel software. After the page loads, scroll down until you see the ScripTouch Sign and Save area. Then click the blue Download Now button to download and start installing the software to your Citrix desktop. When the End User License Agreement is shown, you must confirm that you accept the terms of the license agreement by clicking on the radio button. I'm going to minimize the browser on the Citrix desktop before I begin the next step. Step 5. Run ScripTouch Sign and Save on the Citrix server. Double-click the Sign and Save icon to open the Sign and Save program. At this point, Sign and Save on the Citrix server is ready to receive input from the pad. As you can see, the pad is working correctly on the system. If you are having problems getting your ScripTel pad to work correctly, please visit our developers FAQ page at scriptel.com/developers/developers-FAQ or contact us through email or telephone and we'll be happy to help you. Thank you for watching.